Can you give me a sense of what it's like to be in the presence of Pope Francis?
He's a wonderful man. He projects the kind of humility and kindness that is consistent with my understanding, at least, of Jesus' teachings. His simplicity and his belief in the power of the spiritual over the material reflects itself in everything that he says and does. And I suspect, my sense is that he's a little bit uncomfortable with all the trappings of being Pope.
Embarrassed by them.
Well, you know, that's not his style. And that is part of why I think he has been so embraced around the world, because people get a sense that first and foremost he sees himself as a priest and as a disciple of Christ and as somebody who is concerned with you know, the least of these.
What did the Pope say to you in that meeting that inspired you?
We spent a bulk of our conversation around issues of poverty and inequality, themes that he's been talking about quite a bit, and obviously issues that I care about deeply. The very poor finding fewer and fewer ladders to get into the middle class, youth unemployment high. You know, these are chronic problems. What the Pope's able to do in a way that no politician to do is to shake people's conscience and to shine a light on the problem. It's our job to come up with policies to do something. What the Pope can do is to help mobilize public opinion.
But how practical is that? Stalin once said of the power of the papacy, how many divisions does the Pope have?
I'm a big believer in the power of conscience, the power of faith, the power of a message of hope. I think over time that's what moves history. Tanks and divisions and dollars and sense, you know, all those things obviously make a difference. But ideas are the most powerful thing on earth.